Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us today at Hitachi Investor Day. Today, I would like to start with a general overview and then introduce you to the new CSO and CRMO, Brice. Because it's his first time to participate. Then, each leader managing the business will explain the growth strategies for each of the areas of digital, green, and connective. And CFO Kato will discuss the financial strategies to support growth in his session, followed by a Q&A with all the speakers in the room. We hope you will stay with us until the very end. The next slide, please. Hitachi has been on a journey of transformation to become a global leader in the social innovation business for more than 10 years. After structural reforms up to MMP 21, the current 2024 medium-term plan has made a major shift toward organic growth. Lumada will be our main focus, and we are accelerating our growth, moving away from being a conglomerate to becoming a digital-centric company. Last year, as you know, a technology with an extremely large impact was introduced, and it is the generative AI. In the MMP 24 and the plans to follow, it is important to maximize the business opportunities that this generative AI brings. Furthermore, there will be more innovations in the future that will have as much impact as generative AI. So we do not want to settle for the status quo. We should not be complacent, but rather to be a company that continues to create value aggressively, always envisioning the next inflection point. Let me provide a brief review of the structural reform phase of MMP 15 to MMP 21. We began by establishing a business vision of social innovation. We launched Lumada based on the belief that digital technology was essential to realizing this business vision. And we have decisively reformed our business portfolio in line with that vision. This structural reform was supported by a strong top global-class governance structure that we've had. Based on the results of these structural reforms, MMP 24 was designed to achieve organic growth. We made a major shift toward that in our mode of management. Using the tailwind of DX and GX, we are growing the top line and are driving profit margin improvement with Lumada's business expansion. Our top priority is to strengthen our ability to generate cash. Core free cash flow has grown steadily, allowing us to balance our allocation between investment for growth and returns to shareholders. We have also changed our compensation incentives in order to become a company that always pursues the keyword growth, even in a difficult environment. And it was in this context that the generative AI emerged. The impact that generative AI will have on the market in the short, medium, and long term will be extremely significant. As you can see on this slide, the generative AI is expected to become a key technology that solves a variety of social issues. In particular, the ability to reap the productivity gains that generative AI brings is of vital existential importance to all companies. On the other hand, generative AI has revealed new issues, such as semiconductor supply shortages, rapidly growing demand for data centers, and worsening power shortages that are becoming serious. solving the new challenges that the generative AI brings, also for us, is a great business opportunity. In the short term, as you can see on this slide, resolving the shortage of engineers in the software development and increasing demand for data center related systems, growing demand for semiconductor manufacturing and testing equipment, these are all major business opportunities for Hitachi. Moreover, these are significant opportunities for one Hitachi because they span across all of Hitachi's business sectors. After this, the Executive Vice President who oversees each of the various sectors will discuss the situation. On the other hand, in the medium to long term, there are going to be challenges such as provision of stable supply of power that will be needed as the number of data centers increases, or increasing productivity among workers in field operations, which account for 80% of the world's workforce, because they're faced with a serious labor shortage, and addressing risks associated with promoting the use of AI, such as safety and reliability. How are you going to address these challenges? These challenges and their solutions provide further business opportunities for us. We believe that Hitachi's IT, OT, and products listed here, we believe, are key to capturing these business opportunities. As such, the emergence of generative AI brings great opportunities to our business. Major inflection points such as generative AI will continue to emerge, along with becoming a means of solving various social issues. And they will bring new social challenges as well. So we will actively invest in corporate venturing and other activities to identify the technologies that will create the next tipping point or inflection point, and prepare a portfolio of technologies and businesses through R&D, M&A, etc., with a certain degree of anticipation of the next inflection point. When an inflection point emerges, we will use the impact of the turning point as a business opportunity to accelerate growth through rapid investment. And by repeating such a cycle, we aim to become a company that leverages such inflection points for growth and enhanced corporate value. One thing to note here is that generative AI has the potential to greatly improve research productivity as well. This will maybe allow the next inflection points in quantum computation, anti-aging, nuclear fusion, and so forth, which were thought to be far away from commercialization, to come sooner than expected. To judge this, steady activities listed here are going to be important. In other words, we will work on open innovation by building a global ecosystem with the academia. We will also invest in and collaborate with startup companies through corporate venturing and create breakthrough technologies through backcast type R&D. We will continue to invest in these activities over the medium to long term. What is important, along with the discussion for the future when considering corporate value enhancement, is the so-called housekeeping perspective. First, growth investments must be disciplined and focused on investment returns. Continuous improvement in our PMI capabilities and management of investment risk is essential to our growth model. Capital investment is also critical, and the key there is to balance aggressiveness with avoidance of overcapacity. Complexity is also a major risk to our management. The portfolio also needs to be constantly thought through and implemented with simplification. For asset sales and JVs, business alliances, we will continue to make business decisions with an emphasis on capital efficiency. At today's Investor Day, we would like to share with you the new growth opportunities Hitachi is seizing and how it is accelerating its evolution. We have prepared this forum from the viewpoint of providing you with the content that reaffirms Hitachi's growth potential, and I hope you will stay with us until the very end. Now, following my presentation, Executive Vice President Brice Koch, who also serves as CSO and CRMO, will share his enthusiasm for his mission to manage the opportunities and risks of global growth at One Hitachi, which is a major challenge for us. How will he provide resolution to that? He will be sharing his passion on that topic.